What's up, y'all? This is the 660 I just built. I've had this cylinder that Cajun sent me probably for 3 months. Cajun wanted me to port him a 660 cylinder, so of course I'm going to do it. And I just, Black Friday, I ordered this kit from China, from Farmertech. So I told him I wanted to wait till I got the saw in so I could stick it together and, you know, run my numbers and do everything I need to do, and then, of course, run it. So he was cool with that. He wasn't in a hurry. So then I got really busy building saws for people. So I finally got a break, and I threw this kit together. And it's a Duke's Nicosil cylinder. 54 millimeter standard bore, and I did my thing on it. He liked how the last one I built ran, the one I sold to Goats Firewood and Farm and Firewood, whatever. Everybody knows Goats. Anyway, he liked how it ran. Well, he said he wanted this for like stumping and you know, just hogging on big stuff. So I thought I'd go a little lower on my exhaust roof. Just add a little more added torque for a longer bar. So I went 97 on the exhaust port. It's got 19 blowdown. But to keep my RPMs up, I kept my intake at 78, which required about that much epoxy in the floor of the intake. Wouldn't have mattered. The intake was 87 when I got done machining it. That's garbage, guys. I need to make the cylinders a little better. I had way too much intake timing. Then I'll spit back through the carburetor and it'll be sluggish. That won't work. So I epoxied it up to 78. I think it pulls pretty good what I've run it. I've run about 2/3 of a tank through it. So we're gonna rip these five pieces here, and Cajun's, what videos Cajun's seen, he says he's happy with it. But I've never been more nervous in my life porting a cylinder than I am right now. For Cajun. Isn't that crazy?
Yep.
I mean, if it wasn't for Cajun, I wouldn't be here doing this.
Thank you.
See much point in me running it anymore.
There you go.